need y'all to make some noise. Come on, clap your hands, do something. Wow, this is my first time here. I'm a spoken word artist. I go by the name of Black Ice. I'm the president and founder of the organization Poet, People of Extraordinary Talent. And I'm going to share some poetry with you. And I want to share my testimony with you. I guess it's best to introduce yourself and get to know someone by telling their story. The name of this poem is called Ego. It's an acronym that stands for Easing God Out. Hey God, where you at? I've been looking for you. Seems like you've been avoiding me or something. And I've been searching for you for years with no answer, just anticipation. And I've been going through this transformation, but every time I call on you, God, it's like I get put on hold. And they say that you hear all and that you see all, but seems like you ain't never available, God, when I call. See, Connor, I remember it was January 91. I had just left Simeon's High School's Martin Luther King ceremony speaking. I wasn't feeling too well that day. Little did I know that all the while, my appendix had been leaking. And where were you, God? Just what I thought, nowhere to be found. And if it wasn't for my son's mother convincing me to go to St. Bernard's that night, Black Ice wouldn't be here with you at Beverly Arts Center right now. And where were you at, God, that morning when I went to work and when I got to 123rd and Kedzie, right by the cemetery, this lady ran the light. The last thing I saw, y'all, was headlights. A three-car collision that almost took my life, but where were you, God? And where were you at, God, when my mother was stricken with cervical cancer? She's been going to church serving him since before I was born, and we both called on you, and you still didn't answer. Come on, God, this is my mother. Tell me, is this how you treat all your sons and your daughters? And where were you at, God, that day my son died? I sat there at the University of Chicago, and I watched him come back twice. You could have intervened. You could have saved his life, but... but where were you, God? And where were you at, God, when... okay, my son, I've heard enough. Now I know the times for you have been rough, but son, where's your faith? Seems like you only seek my face when you need me. For I am a full-time God, my son. Do you really believe in me? Well, if so, then you would know that I am the creator of the universe. All that you see from the highest heights of heaven to what you have discovered beneath the earth. See, I am the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. I am the God of Moses, Lot, and David. I am the one who made Solomon wise. I put Noah in the ark before the waters could rise. I gave Samson the strength to destroy the Philistines with no eyes. I am that smooth stone that David slung that smote Goliath in the head. The cracks that crumbled the walls of Jericho, the same one that rose Lazarus from the dead. I am the blood of the lamb of the doorpost that kept the children of Israel safe from harm. Even the staff of Moses' right arm, and I gave it the power to split the Red Sea in half. Shall I go on? Please forgive me, Father. He said, no, son, I already have. But see, like Jonah, you've been running from your mission. I've been trying to reach you and speak to you for years, but your ego just wouldn't let you listen. See, when your appendix was spreading poison through your body, I was the voice that spake to your son's mother warning you, and do you remember what you promised me, my son? Yes, Lord, I do. I promise you that if you allow me to make it through, then I will turn my life over to you. But what did you do? You continued to play. So I spoke to you again in the form of a three-car collision, but I allowed you to walk away that day. And have you ever asked yourself the question why the accident was by a gravesite? I was showing you that the road that you were traveling on ended at the cemetery if you didn't change your life. But you still didn't listen. and ask for your mother's cervical cancer. I am the reason why your mother's cancer is in remission, and I know your son's gone. But his body was sick, so I relieved him of his pain, and I called him home. And yet and still I stayed by your side all those moments that you felt alone, yet you still rejected my truth. If you only could have put your ego to the side and listened to all those whom I said to you. Lord, you mean to tell me what all the while I was waiting to hear from you? You were sending me messages to all those whom I rejected? Yes, my son, this is true. And instead of focusing on the gods, submit to the truth that you find inside. For Satan is the one who subtracts and divides, but he is the one who adds and multiplies. I'm telling y'all, he opened my eyes. And so to those of you who can't accept the truth, because your ego will allow you to accept who the truth is coming through, take this as a lesson. Because see, God just ain't using these pastors today, because asking some of these pastors questions is just like asking blind men for directions. But it's the truth that counts. And see, in this case, my ego just wasn't my ego. But my ego was easing God out. Thank you so much.